Japan's mission is to create a sustainable future for the next generation. As advancing science and technology has become essential for social development and human progress, it has never been more important to sustainably secure mineral resources that can power green technology, now and into the future, as well as pursuing higher level of recycling and alternative resources development. These include minor metals such as nickel and cobalt, and mineral resources like gold and copper. The challenge is that these resources can only be found in a limited number of places on Earth. Take cobalt, for example. It is a basic element used in high-performance batteries that people rely on every day. However, more than half of cobalt's global supply is concentrated in sensitive environments in Africa. As demand has increased, prices rapidly rose from 2016 to 2018. Similarly, nickel, which is essential for the development of electric vehicles, will require new sources to supply and power our future. The demand for nickel has also increased sharply. From 2019 to 2029, demand is expected to increase 57% overall. These resources, once abundant on land, have begun to decline rapidly in recent years as demand increases. In the meantime, there are resources that lie in the deep sea that should not be overlooked for the potential they provide to power sustainable technologies and to ensure their widespread availability. Careful extraction of mineral resources from the seabed, with consideration of the protection of marine biodiversity, can be a long-term solution to the realization of a more sustainable future. Any effort to promote the development of marine mineral resources requires an approach that is balanced with the protection of the environment. For this reason, the Japanese government has been conducting surveys and research for over 40 years. Japan's research is also being shared internationally to enhance our understanding of the ocean. Japan takes pride in its long-standing commitment and international leadership on research in the deep ocean. For example, in a pilot study conducted in 2017, Japan became the first country in the world to successfully lift ores from a seafloor hydrothermal deposit. The result of the study boosted understandings of the seabed ecosystem and how the environment actually responded to the extraction activities. In 2020, Japan conducted the world's first successful excavation test of cobalt-rich seabed in the deep ocean, marking a major technological step forward in the development of its ocean mineral resources. While conducting the first-of-its-kind excavation test, Japan took the potential environmental impact seriously by facilitating an assessment and monitoring activities to ensure the integrity of the test and that the ecosystem remained intact. It is Japan's hope that after decades of research and its accomplishments in deep-sea mining, it will continue to lead the way on the global stage. To secure a balance between the need for resources that power sustainable technology and environmental conservation, it is essential for the international community to cooperate in accordance with fair and equitable rules based on the framework of the International Seabed Authority, ISA, which was established under United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea, UNCLOS. Japan has long been one of the largest donors to the ISA. In addition to that, Japan contributes to a number of programs established under the ISA to develop human resources in developing countries. Contractors like JOGMEC provide capacity-building training programs around the world. Japan will continue to actively participate in dialogue with the international community and contribute to research and development. We must all work together to achieve a more sustainable future.